Hello friend, welcome to Tanya's Biology. Today my topic is about active transport. In my previous class, I already have described about the membrane transport system. Now this membrane transport system is divided into two types. One is active transport, another one is passive transport. Today I will briefly describe about the active transport. If you want to get my previous video, please you like my channel, also share and subscribe. Okay, let me start. What is active transport? When the molecules need to be passes from low concentration to high concentration, from low to high concentration, it needs some energy. Without that energy, they are not able to penetrate the membrane. This is known as active transport. Here you can see this is a plasma membrane structure. These are the region where the head is known as, these are the tail region, hydrophobic region, hydrophilic region. Okay, hydrophobic, this one is the hydrophobic region, the tail region, and hydrophilic region is the head region. Okay, water can easily penetrate through the hydrophilic region but unable to penetrate through the hydrophobic region. Here you can see the blue portion. This is a channel protein. This is channel protein or carrier protein. There are two types of channel protein. One is channel, another one is carrier molecule. Okay. Here you can see a carrier molecule which is form of protein. Okay. Through this channel, molecules are passes through the low concentration to the high concentration. When that means they are passing from the against the concentration gradient, against the concentration gradient. Before I describe about the what is concentration differentiation, I'll already describe about the transmembrane part. Okay, when the molecules need to be passes from low to high, they need some energy. Without that energy, they are unable to penetrate. What is that the energy? ATP is the energy. This ATP is required in case of active transport. In case of passive transport, they doesn't require any ATP. Why they use ATP? ATP is a form of energy. We can say that ATP is a unit of energy. Okay. Without the help of any ATP, active transport is not possible. Okay, if we differentiate what is the primary active transport and secondary active transport, we can discuss it. Okay, when we divide the active transport in two parts, what we will get? One is primary active transport, another one is secondary active transport. What is primary active transport? Transport of molecule from one region to their destination region. That means where they want to go. That means that if we consider this as a plasma membrane, there are some sodium ions which are low in inside, high in outside. So it need to be passes from low, high to low concentration. It was not that much difficult. But when the transformation was low to high, what will happen? They need some channel protein as well as some ATP. They need some channel protein as well as some ATP. I already described that this ion-gated channel help the ions from passes to the low, high to low or low to high concentration. In this case of sodium, sodium ion need to be passes from low to high concentration. That's why they need ATP as well as with the help of this ion gated channel. With the help of this ion gated channel, molecules are able to pass from the low concentration to high concentration. This is known as primary active transport. Why? Because they only need ATP. Okay. In this case, the channels look like this. One side is open for ATP. One side is open for ATP. In the another side, they will bind with the other destination molecule. Which molecule need to be passes from the low concentration to high concentration? That means there is a specific site for ATP. This is known as ATP binding site. This is known as ATP binding site. Okay. Now, what is secondary transport? Secondary transport is also known as energy coupled process. What's that? That means they don't use ATP directly as like as the primary active transport. They don't use ATP directly. Okay, what will happen? If the glucose concentration is low or it's high outside or low inside, but the cell always need glucose because they need energy. Okay, when this glucose need to be passes from low to high or high to low, what is the condition? That doesn't matter. The always the cell need to have glucose. Okay, if the glucose is higher in the inner side and lower in the outer side, also it happen in case of secondary active transport. What will happen then? Glucose in that form channel, it look like this. One is ATP binding site, one is sodium binding site, because sodium helps glucose to go inside. Sodium helps glucose to go inside. This is ATP, and this I can say sodium ion. Another one is, let me draw, glucose. Okay, when sodium moves higher concentration to lower concentration, that means higher outside, okay, and lower inside. When sodium moves our higher concentration to lower concentration, it produces energy, ATP. Okay, if this ATP is not available in this case, also the secondary transport is occur. If this ATP is not available in this case, also secondary transport will occur. What will happen then? Sodium when moves from higher concentration to lower concentration, it produces energy, ATP. This ATP pull the glucose to move from the low concentration to high concentration. When the ATP moves from high concentration to low concentration, it produces energy, ATP. This ATP help the glucose to pull it from outside to inside. Okay, this is secondary active transport. Now, this active transport is divided into three parts. One is uniport, one is symport, another one is antiport. What is uniport, symport and antiport? These are the three modes of transportation. When the molecules are passes from lower to higher or higher to lower in one direction, the direction is one. When one molecule is transported from higher to lower or lower to higher, it is known as uniport, when one molecule is there. Okay. What is symport? Symport is a type of, we can say that it is a type of secondary transport. Why? Because there are two molecules are involved. There are two molecules are involved. When two molecules moves in the same direction, when two molecules move in same direction is known as symport. Okay, in case of sodium and glucose, this will happen. In case of sodium and glucose, this will happen. What will happen? Two molecules move in the same side. If the two molecules moves in different side, if you can see that the black one moves from different side and the red one moves the different side. That means when the two molecules which are moving from low to high or high to low, from inside to outside or outside to inside are different. One is moving from out to in, another is moving from in to out. That is known as antipode. Okay. So you, from this lecture, you can see that what is active transport? Active transport is divided into two parts. One is primary active transport, another one is secondary active transport. And also you learn that there are three modes of transportation in active transport. In my next video, I will briefly describe about the passive transport. So if you want to get that video, please like, comment, share and subscribe my channel.